years or a few days. We'd like to do it in as short a time as possible. You need better propulsion to do that than what we currently have. You're absolutely right. The problem is, suppose the original settlers said, I'm not going to go to California until I get there in 5 hours. No one would have ever reached the West Coast. So it's unrealistic to say, wait until something better happens, and until then, don't do anything. It's not been the way of exploration in the past. You do it when you can, not when you think you can do it better. And so, I'm just describing the urges that people have as explorers themselves. We have a question from the peanut gallery up there. Just raise your hand or I'll recognize you. If not, we'll come right back down. Yes, sir.
Is perhaps part of the solution not necessarily approaching meaning engineering and mathematics and science so we can continue to say we're the best nation in the world? Or perhaps the motivation could be we're going to do this for the betterment of humanity?
Okay, so the question is, what's the motivation that we should invoke for ourselves? Is it so we have bragging rights, or is it just because it's the right thing to do? Is that a fair paraphrase? Sure. So here's the problem. It's rare when humans ever do anything for noble reasons. If something looks like it's done for a noble reason, you part the curtains, there's something else going on behind it. In fact, you remember Kennedy's speech, where he says, we will put a man on the moon and return safely to Earth. If you go to Kennedy Space Center, Florida, there's a bust of Kennedy in the main lobby. There's a granite wall, chiseled in the granite are those words. And you say, back then we had leaders, we had visionary, and you say, well, wait a minute, which speech was that? That came from, oh, that's the address to the joint session of Congress, May 25th, 1961. I'm going to look up that speech. Okay, I found that phrase. Sure, it's accurately quoted. But what's missing is two paragraphs earlier in the same speech, where he says, if the events of recent weeks, Europe and America just come out of orbit in the Soviet Union, we did not yet have a man-made vehicle. All our stuff was blowing up on the launch pad. If the events of recent weeks are any indication of the impact of this adventure on the minds of men everywhere, then we must show the world the path of freedom over the path of tyranny. That speech was a battle cry against communism. And so if this granite wall were honest, there'd be, because there's plenty of other granite squares there where nothing was in it. Above this square, it should have said, kill the communists. Go to the moon, okay? If they were honest. But that whole period has been cleansed in our memory, and it gets reflected on as some kind of noble invention, when in fact it was completely militaristically driven. Do you realize 1989, July 20th, George Bush Sr. gave a speech not fundamentally different from Kennedy's speech. He talked about explorers and Columbus, and he wanted to go to Mars, recommended we go to Mars on the 20th anniversary of the moon landing. All right? George C. was not quite as charismatic as Kennedy, but all the same words were there. Did we go to Mars? Why, his instructions? No. No. Well, why not? When was the speech given? 1989. What did we agree happened in 1989? Peace broke out. Yes. Peace broke out. Where is the driver? Bush Sr. was not aware that the driver in 1961 was the Cold War. He mistakenly thought it was just the beautiful words laid to paper. In fact, I wrote a whole book on this, coming out in 9 months. It's called Failure to Watch: The Dreams and Delusions of Space Enthusiasts. Although my publisher is trying to get me to change the title. They want to call it Spacebook. Like Facebook, Spacebook. I don't know, we're still arguing about it. But anyhow, so the reasons, so I wish the noble reasons were sufficient to drive money to be spent. The history of human culture says that that is never the case. Now, there's one thing that bragging rights is another thing to be at the front. And the fact of being at the front stimulates your economy. We all want a healthy economy. So it's not only the bragging rights, it's what effect that has on your comfort as a nation and the strength of your economy that we all so value as a capitalist entity. Yes?
This question has less to do about space and more to do about your dealings with education and making science bigger. Wouldn't you say that, as much respect as I have for you in the science community, wouldn't you say that it's kind of a paradox? Scientists want so badly for education to be made bigger in this nation, but on the other hand, we have scientists that are basically making things easier. People don't want things to be hard anymore. People don't want challenges anymore because things are so easy for us and convenient for us. And scientists and engineers have a lot to do with that as well.
You're saying, I'm trying to understand, you're saying the scientists are making things easier for people? In what way? Oh, calculators? Okay, so give me your calculators. And then you go the rest of your life without your head.
I think that means a better profession.
Look, just give me an example so I even know what you're talking about.
An example
of how scientists are making science easy for people.
Not that scientists are making science easy, that scientists, engineers, medical professionals, everybody's making the world so much easier. Not that science is easier.
Give me an example.
Everything is so convenient. There, people don't feel the need to learn as much as they
should. So you're saying we're getting lazy. We're getting laser. Someone says the microwave oven. Microwave oven. Cooking your baked potato in 4 minutes instead of an hour and a half. See, here's why I think that's a problem. I do a fair amount of reading of people's predictions of the future. I like seeing where it's accurate. One of the great predictions at the beginning of the automation movement, if I can call it that, was that the push button home would make things so convenient and so easy, and certain tasks on the job would become so simple because a machine would replace the task, that the day would come where we would have 3-day work weeks. And what those predictions completely got wrong is that if I can do 7 days of work in 3 days, I'm going to continue to work because I want to make even more money in a free capitalist society. If you can make more money, would you not? Some people might not. Some people would rather just sit home and watch American Idol. Fine. But if you had the tools to make your job easier, ask any accountant. Do they like the spreadsheet that they use rather than having to calculate by hand the ledger of the financial books of companies they use to monitor? They'll take the ledger. You know why? They'll take the Microsoft Excel. You know why? Because now they can do it for 10 times as many companies, make 10 times as much money. So, easier doesn't mean less work. Doesn't have to mean less work, but for most people, it doesn't mean less work. I write books on this machine, and I scan 10 billion web pages finding references that I cite that would have taken weeks in a library. So now, by my age, now I've written 10 books instead of 3. It's not that I've only still written 3 books and said, wow, I have nothing to do. I'll just go to the Bahamas. No, I have their ambition is magnified in the face of those features. That's what I think it is. Yes?
My name is Jared O'Neill, I'm practicing the Aerospace Engineering at Mississippi State. My question to you is the same. I was at a conference last week, and I gave the same question to former NASA administrator, Dr. at some of the STEAM conference.
So you're asking that question to me that you're asking them?
Yes.
Does that mean their answer wasn't satisfying enough to you? So now you want to see if I can satisfy you with the answer?
Yes.
We're just collecting opinions.
Well,
you're going to compare and get your best answer. You know?
The question has to do with, and a lot of this has to do with some other people ask, and exploration in general. Big problem has to do with providing better forms of propulsion in general. And that has to do with space operators.
He's worried about propulsion. As I said earlier, our best propulsion today will take 35,000 years to get to the nearest star.
Frankly speaking, not good. The problem has to do